Hi friends, welcome to EduTap. So welcome to the Target NABARD Grade A and B 2019 5 MCQs a Day series. It's a regular series where in each day we come up with a lecture which contains 5 questions. We discuss those questions and we tell you the relevance of those questions as well. And today it is lecture number 22. So we know that the NABARD Grade A and B 2019 notification is out. The NABARD Grade A exam will be held on 15th and 16th of June 2019, NABARD Grade B on 16th of June 2019. The online registrations have begun, so please fill the form ASAP, 5 more days to go. So the last date is 26th of May 2019. So there are 8 vacancies released for Grade B and 79 vacancies for Grade A. We have had some excellent results previously and EduTap has performed well. NABARD Grade A, 11 selections in 2017 and 26 selections in the year 2018. We offer the courses for NABARD 2019, so you can have a look at the courses that are there. So there are courses separately only for NABARD Grade A as well. And if in case you have already taken our RBI course, then you can opt for ARD course separately, Agriculture and Rural Development. And in case you want to prepare for both Grade A and Grade B, you can go for NABARD Grade B plus Grade A course, wherein you will get phase 1 mock test plus phase 2 full video course. And in case you have already taken NABARD Grade A and you have to prepare or you want to prepare for Grade B, then you can take the last course when we'll give you only the paper 3, right? So if you want to avail the discount that we are offering, that is 20%, you can use the code NABARD20. Now these are the combo courses that we offer, and to avail the discount of 30%, you can use the coupon code COMBO30 to avail the same. So friends, we also offer individual courses, which is RBI Grade B, SEBI Grade A, RBI Assistant, IBPS AF4, and we also offer a QRE course, Quant Reasoning and English course, for all banking exams. So friends, what are we doing today? So the previous 2 lectures were actually dedicated to NABARD's model bankable project reports. So here friends, today again these 5 MCQs are based on the model bankable projects of NABARD. Now these are very important, as I had already mentioned that in the previous year there were questions that were directly taken from such reports. Now these reports are very lengthy and it is not easy for us to comprehend, but we need to understand that we just need to focus on the important questions that might be asked in our examination. Now there might be a possibility that there is not much of concept that is involved in these kind of questions. So what you need to do is just memorize these questions. So just let us discuss question number 1. So the question says, in fish cold storages, once a fish is frozen, it must be stored at a constant temperature of how much or below in order to maintain a long shelf life and ensure quality. So basically they are asking the temperature at which the fish should be frozen in cold storages. Okay, so the answer to this question is minus 23 degrees Celsius. So kindly by heart this answer. So here they have given another information that if you see this minus 23 degrees Celsius, there might be a question where the options might be in Fahrenheit. So just have a look at this also. And there's one more information that International Institute of Refrigeration has recommended a storage temperature of minus 18 degrees Celsius for lean fish. Okay, for example, cod and haddock, and minus 24 degrees Celsius for fatty species like herring and mackerel. So this is a kind of second data point that you need to remember. Now let us have a look at question number 2. So this particular question says, India holds which of the following position in the world in terms of production of horticultural crops and fruits? So basically this is regarding India's ranking in the world. So the answer is 2nd. Now this is a small question for you guys. Which country stands first in the world in terms of production of horticultural crops and fruits? Now kindly find it out and mention in the comment section below. So India accounts for about 15% of the world's production of vegetables. That is huge. Now let us discuss question number 3. It says, what is India's rank in the world in terms of tea production? Now the answer to this question is second. So India ranks second in the world in terms of tea production. So now which country ranks first in the world in terms of tea production? Now you have two questions to answer. The first is which country stands first when it comes to the production of horticultural crops, right, and vegetables, and which country stands first in the world in terms of tea production? So kindly mention the answer to these questions in the comment section below. Now let us see the fourth question. It says, which of the following states has the maximum area under tea cultivation in India? So the answer to this question is Assam. Kindly memorize these, friends. So this question is important with regard to phase one. So here you can have a look at an important tabular column. So friends, this is actually the data taken from the year 2013-14. So obviously the data would have changed. But you need to understand that the state that has the maximum area under tea production is still Assam. Okay. So if you see, you can have a rough idea about the data. Okay, and because there's not going to be major changes, slight changes are going to be there. So just pause the video, have a rough idea about the various states that have their area under tea production. Then we come to question number 5. So it says, for successful tea plantation, what is required rainfall range out of the following? Okay, now the answer to this question is 2000 to 5000 mm. Okay, so please by heart, this is the required rainfall range. Now friends, here you can see some important information. This can also be taken as a general information regarding what are the suitable conditions when we want to plant tea. Okay, so here obviously we had seen that the rainfall range is 2000 mm to 5000 mm. So by heart this data point. The second thing is the monthly average maximum temperature should range between 28 degrees Celsius and 32 degrees Celsius during the month of April to September, right? So here you can see the optimum temperature or the maximum temperature that we require. And then moving on to the soil conditions, okay? So the soil conditions, the soil should be sandy loam to silty loam type of soil. So this is the third data point. The first thing was regarding the rainfall range. The second one was regarding the temperature range. The third is regarding the type of soil. And then let us move on to the fourth data point, that is the required pH. Okay, that is 4.5 to 5.5. So again, this is a fourth one. Now the soil should possess a minimum 1% of organic carbon, 1 to 2% of organic matter, 35 parts per million of P2O5 and 80 parts per million of K2O for successful establishment of tea. So instead of going into further details, just make sure that you know the rainfall range, you know the temperature range, the suitable soil conditions, the pH levels, right? So these are some of the data points keep in mind. Now, when is the planting of tea usually done? It is usually done in spring. Okay, that is in the month of June, July, after the first few showers of rain, or it may also be done in autumn, that is October, November, because in that month the soil is still moist. Okay, and we also have the facility of irrigation. So kindly pause the video and make sure that you remember all these data points. Now these are the answers for the questions that we had discussed today. So friends, if you have any queries, you can drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in. You can give us a call on 814-620-7241. You can go to our website if you want to have a look at the course features, www.edutab.co.in. So till then friends, thank you so much for watching, and as usual, happy learning.